express your creativity to the glory of God. Enjoy watching. Hello everyone, Samantha here. So in this video, I'm going to be journaling on day 5 for the March Journal Challenge and Jesus Journal Junkies. We're journaling through the Gospel according to John. And so what I wanted to do is I wanted to read the scriptures. I just wanted to read tonight a little bit more than just a verse in the video. So I'm going to read John chapter 3 verses 22 through 26 and then share what my key verse is, and then we'll go into the creative part of the journaling. So 3 verse 22 through 36. John the Baptist exhorts Christ. After these things, Jesus and his disciples came into the land of Judea, and there he remained with them and baptized. Okay. Jesus baptized. There he remained and baptized. Now John also was baptizing in Aenon near Salim, because there was much water there. And they came and were baptized, for John had not yet been thrown into prison. Then there arose a dispute between some of John's disciples and the Jews about purification. And they came to John and said to him, "Rabbi, he who was with you beyond the Jordan, to whom you have testified, behold, he is baptizing, and all are coming to him." John answered and said, "A man can receive nothing unless it has been given to him from heaven. You yourselves bear me witness that I said, I am not the Christ, but I have been sent before him. He who has the bride is the bridegroom, but the friend of the bridegroom who stands and hears him rejoices greatly because of the bridegroom's voice. Therefore, this joy of mine is fulfilled. He must increase, but I must decrease. He who comes from above is above all. He who is of the earth is earthly and speaks of the earth. He who comes from heaven is above all. And what he has seen and heard, that he testifies. And no one receives his testimony. He who has received his testimony has certified that God is true. For he whom God has sent speaks the words of God. For God does not give the Spirit by measure. The Father loves the Son and has given all things into his hand. He who believes in the Son has everlasting life, and he who does not believe the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides on him." Okay, so I took some time to go off camera and think about like what verse I was going to journal on as my key verse, because it was a lot in that passage that I really that really spoke to my heart. But I'm going to go with, I was praying too, and I started to choose which one was it? The one that says a man can receive nothing. Right, I started to choose verse 27. John answered and said, "A man can receive nothing unless it has been given to him from heaven." But no, when I went to go highlight, the Lord was like, "No, it's verse 30. He must increase, but I must decrease." And I'm highlighting it purple because according to my color coding, my purple is for instruction. And I know that's what the Lord is saying to me. Even today, I noticed this morning it was some things that was like on my heart, and I didn't want to resist God. And the Holy Spirit had me pray. I said, God, just help me to just surrender. Let me just surrender my will to you. I just want you to use me as you see fit. Like, you know, and I wasn't sure that I wasn't sure if I was resisting God, but I just know when I have feel a certain way, I get mindful, like, because, you know, we're human and we have emotions, and sometimes God is in our lack of desire, and sometimes he's in our desire for something. But I just want to make sure that I'm just in step with him, and I don't want to kick up against the pricks, and I don't want to resist the Holy Spirit. And this reminds me of today. He must increase, but I must decrease. I was saying, Lord, like, let me, you reign through me. You rule, you reign. Not my will, but thy will be done. You know, in this context, you know, Jesus was baptizing, and John's disciples was like, what is he doing baptizing? And John had to let them know, this is not about me standing up for my rights. Like, oh, Jesus, you're not supposed to be baptizing because I'm the one that's baptizing. You know, he's saying he's on the scene now. Now he's going into his ministry. Jesus is going into his ministry. He's baptizing now. So now I have to decrease and he must increase. It makes me think almost like a success, like a successor. You know, maybe we've been doing something for a while, but somebody else comes on the scene and it's their time now to do it. And we have to take a back seat. You know, that's not easy. The flesh wants to kick up, or, you know, like, I don't want to give up. We don't want to give up our right, or this belongs to us. We should have this. We should be the one doing it. And God is like, no, when you do what I want you to do, when it's not your time to do it anymore, you won't do it anymore. Someone else will do it. I have someone else to do it. And, you know, God knows what's best for us. But again, he must increase, but I must decrease. And so that really, really resonates with me, especially when I think about like what I was praying this morning. And I did see that in some ways, like my attitude with certain things was different today. It was different. And not different in a sense of like, how can I say, like, I'm like a whole turnaround from, oh, I don't probably want to do something. But it was just like this song that I listened to is Beauty in the Waiting. Like, I didn't feel, I know that I need to make changes, but, and God is making those changes, but it wasn't just like, I wasn't feeling so downtrodden emotionally when I thought about that particular area that needed to change. Okay. And that was because he allowed me to decrease and he increased in that area. So that means his peace, his joy, you know, just communing with him in the process. So anyway, so I'm going to journal on that. He must increase, but I must decrease. So let me go into what I'm going to use to journal on this particular verse. Hold on. So I am going to use some watercolor postcards because I'm going to make a piece of art on here. And then I'm going to make a copy of it on a bigger sheet of paper where I'm going to write some notes. I'm going to use this gelato book, and I'm going to use a technique that I saw in this book. And the technique is textural variations. Number 3, use bubble wrap as your stamp. Coat the bubbles with gelatos in either water, gesso or glaze and press. So that's what this one right here looks like. So I was going through some of my papers yesterday and I realized that I had made a stamp, one second, a long time ago with some bubble wrap. What I did was I took the stamp, the bubble wrap, and I adhered it to a piece of envelope, right? And so I'm going to use that. And of course, I'm going to use these gelato. I don't know what colors I'm going to use yet. Okay, so let me move these pens out the way. Hold on one second. Okay. I'm thinking I'm going to use this purple highlighter. I'm not sure to do something different with it. I may or may not. It depends. Okay, and there's some, I have some letters here. And I even have some more. So I'm going to use some letters. I might use some of this tissue paper. So I don't know everything that I'm going to use just yet, but I will, when I upload the video, I'm going to put a list. So it'll be there, because sometimes some things come to me spontaneously. So I just want to be mindful not to get all crazy about having to know everything up front. Sometimes I know it, sometimes I don't. So hold on. Okay, so I want to say something. I'm not going to, because I'm not going to talk throughout the rest of the video. I'm just going to show the process. But I did want to say, yesterday, my husband and I, we were praying and we were praying and worshiping, and my husband started praying, and prophetically the Lord had given me a song, and one of the things he kept saying to me was, Jesus reign, Jesus reign, Lord, you reign in our hearts, Lord, you reign in our mind, Lord, you reign in our lives. And then my husband, he was talking about our finances, and he just started lifting up different areas in our lives. And the Lord was just having me say and sing, you reign, you reign, you reign. I'm not singing it now because the Lord ain't telling me to do that, but to do that right now. So I don't want to just try to conjure that up. But he just told me to share that word, that he reigns. And it's so funny because he must increase and I must decrease. That is so connected to him reigning. And I'm just so blessed by that. It's like, yes, Lord, you reign. And of his government, there shall be no end. And of the increase, of his government, there shall be no end. You are worthy, Lord, to reign. That's a song. And I'm going to see if I can actually play the song when I'm doing the journaling part. I'm going to see if I can get that by that song tonight and see if I could put it with the video. Yeah. So I just wanted to say that again, and of his increase and of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end. That's Isaiah 9:7. And then the other part of the song, you are worthy, Lord, to reign. Okay, so that's it. Thanks for watching. God bless you. And remember, Jesus loves you. Most likely, I'll probably come back at the end to explain what I did in a bit more detail. Okay.
There shall be no end. There shall be So tired of living life the same old way. Trial slowly eating away at me. I need a touch from the Lord today. Oh, revival. We must reconcile. I wanna be like Jesus, deliver, set free. How can I reach out to someone else when I ain't got it together myself? I'm just stuck playing the cards I was dealt. In my heart, I'm crying out for help. I'm looking for purity, self-control and immunity. Said I wanna be like Jesus, deliver, set free.
Baby, better than I was before. Oh Lord, please start over.
Give me those things
I need more.
Okay, I'm back. And so that was the process for this. I'm now going to, I was going to use a white piece of paper so I can like easily put it inside of my wall binder, but I still will be able to do that. I would just have to attach another piece of paper and staple it, put the holes on the extension piece. So right now I'm just going to journal on that verse. So I'm going to put the date here, which is 3/5/18, and I'm going to put the scripture. Right, which is John 3:30. Right, and let me get my, I'll put my Bible back. I'm gonna get it out right now. John 3:30. So I'm looking at another Bible right now. That was a New King James Version I read earlier. So I'm going to just go ahead and get this one. 3:30. Other one I've gotten under some papers. Okay, he must increase, but I must decrease. So it's he must increase. He must increase, but I must decrease. Okay. So I'm going to journal on that and then I'll come right back and read what I wrote.
Time for me to get this straight. So tired of living life the same old way. Trial slowly eating away at me. I need a touch from the Lord today. Oh, revival. We must reconcile. I wanna be like Jesus, deliver. set free. How can I reach out to someone else when I ain't got it together myself? I'm just stuck playing the cards I was dealt. In my heart, I'm crying out for help. I'm looking for purity, self-control and immunity. Said I wanna be like Jesus, deliver, set free.
Better than I was before. Oh Lord, please start over.
Give me those things. I need more.
I'm done, and I'm gonna read this and then show how I'm gonna attach this card to this journaling page right here. So I wrote scripture, John 3:30, he must increase but I must decrease. Thoughts: Jesus reigns in my mind, heart, life and soul. I should put body there too, and I am gonna put it in my mind, body, heart, life, and soul. He is my God, and I, by grace alone, totally surrender to him. I have to say that because you'll see what I'm about to say. I, by grace alone, totally surrender to him by his grace. I guess I put it two times. It's okay. By his grace and power of the Holy Spirit. I know this means I have to daily surrender my will to him and allow him to have lordship and not resist him. I can't do this on my own. However, I trust him to empower me to decrease daily, which is die to my flesh, and let him increase in every area of my life. I relinquish control and submit my desires to him by the power of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. And then I wrote, Father God, hear my prayer. Father God, thanks for new life in you. Thanks for ruling and reigning in my mind, heart, and life. Lord, I ask for your strength not to draw back, but to humble myself before you daily. You alone are God, and beside you, there is no other. I'm always in need of your strength, love, and power to submit to you and obey you. You reign, God, you reign. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So, those are some thoughts in prayer. And I will say this. It's this scripture that says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. And I was kind of nervous. Writing that, I'm not gonna lie, I was kind of nervous, because I know it's daily. Like, when I say totally surrender, that's because, you know, by his grace today, I said, yes, Lord. But I know every day it's gonna take him to help me. This is not a one-time thing. We have to surrender. Oops, gotta be careful, this thing is sharp. We have to surrender our will daily. Hold on. I may have to do it like that. Okay, that's better. So I'm putting another bell here. Turn it around. This paper is very thin, so I have to be careful. But I like it because it looks kind of old. And then I'm gonna put another bell here. I like these bells. Put another one right here. Yeah, good. We'll put the same kind. This one. Alrighty. Yeah, so yeah, I say I read that I did that with much trembling. Like, be humble, because I will, let me make sure I put by grace alone, totally surrender. Because I ain't trying to be like I'm all that, and no. So that's that for that. And then I can actually put in my binder. I think I'm gonna try to show how I'm gonna do that. So yeah, so hold on. So right now I'm going to, this is that sticker. It's kind of, that sticker paper is kind of hard. So I'm going to use that. So I'm going to cut it down. I already went like that to see the length that I need. And I'm going to trim this right here. Yeah, so it's kind of late now. Time to retire for the night. Uh-oh. I hope. Okay, it's all right. And so, I don't think I need too much of a big piece, so I'm just going to cut off enough where I can just... Okay. So, that should be for that. I have a little sticker bag hack that I was thinking about showing. I might just go ahead and... do that. Let me see. Do I want the glossy side, or I think I want to do this side. Yeah, I think I will do that side. So I'm gonna put this Recollections here. Oh no. Before I do that, you know what I'm gonna do? Let me get my wall binder. Hold on 1 second. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. So what I wanted to do is like take this and see how it was going to be able to, how I would have to like stamp, hole punch it. So it will go like right up at the top. So I'm gonna punch the holes first. And then, okay, so I did that one. Okay. So I punched the holes first. And now I know that this, it's gonna fit like this, but I'm about to, hold on 1 second. Okay, is that okay there? It's sticking up a little bit out. Oh no, it's all right. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is, let me put this here. Okay, I got the Recollections, right? And so put it like this, right? So I'm gonna put the adhesive. My husband's in there cracking up over something. I like to hear him laugh. When he laughs, it makes me laugh. Because his laugh is hearty. Okay, so that's good right there. I might even put a little bit. Do I need to? No. I'm not going to do that. I'm about to go and do something I ain't got no business doing. So I did that right there. Oh, then again, you know what? Let me see something. Maybe I can. Hold on 1 second. Since it's flipping up this way, maybe... Well, looky there. It worked. Okay. Because I thought I was, when I just tried it, I was at the corners, I could see myself ripping something. I got kind of nervous. Hold on, let me see if I can do it right here. And then do that. Yeah, that worked nicely. Oh, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, so I got the paper down. This is, okay, that's cool. All right. Let me close this back up. And so now, let me see what it'll look like in my binder. Okay, so that was day 4. This is day 5. I'm going to have to go and put day 4, day 5, and all that in there, too. But this is day 5. And that fits in there. Right? And I could even, like, flap it, like, go like this if I want, you know, if I'm concerned about it getting like messed up or ruined. But let me see, will it? Yeah, I'm not going to take any chances, so I'm going to make my copy of it, and then my picture of it, take my picture of it, and then I'm going to put it like so. you know, when it's a whole full 30 days, I'll probably take it and store it somewhere anyway. I'll see. I'll cross that road when I get to it. I'm be anxious for nothing. So this is it. I'm really pleased with it. And I just want to say thank you. Thanks for watching. I'm really pleased with it. I'm so pleased because it's different. And I like this scraggly edges. You know, I really like that vintage type of, that old vintage look. So, okay. So that's it. Again, thanks for watching. God bless you. And remember, Jesus loves you and Jesus reigns. He reigns. Amen. Bye-bye.
Make me better. Make me better. I need more of you. You, I feel better.
I feel better.
Hey, I feel better.
Now that I have
better. I feel better.
Ooh.
I got more.